Hey everybody, Rhadamant here. Thanks for tuning in to Darkest Dungeon. So my last journey I took gives me a little bit of extra resolve and damage in the warrens on this quest. So if we take a look at the warrens here, we do have this boss here that we are absolutely going to do now with that bonus damage. So the idea here is to... Before I change the party order here, let's celebrate our first champion, Angelia. She is our Uber Frau here. So I have a lot of people with diseases. I wanted to go over some tips, too. So the first tip was that I should bring a plague doctor on medium or longer excursions so that I can use their camping skill to cure my people. Let's see. This is a disease resist, remove bleeding, remove disease. There it is, leeches. Yes, that would be very, very wise of me if I had diseases. I do, of course, have diseases, but for right now, I'm going to spend the bucks to go put them into the medical ward. All right. Now I need to field a group to take on that boss there, and I really only have four people that are even allowed to go do it, so it's pretty easy to pick my lineup. It's going to be DeFay, Emery, Drool, and Acid. It has to be, because they're the only ones that can face such a simple boss. First things first, unequip all my trinkets, and then let's trinket up these guys. Because it is a boss, I don't want to mess around. I want to basically wallop the boss, as I try to do always. So let's go ahead and put big old heals on. Where's my... Oh, that's down there. Let's go ahead and sort by rarity. So my good stuff is at the top. Let's see. Torch on you. My plague doc. I really don't know. Actually, you know what? Torch on the dock. Speed cloak on you. Maybe some bleed dice. I'll leave one slot open on acid for a trinket that I pick up. And let's put another trinket on you. Oh boy, I'm really tempted to do that, but I'd rather have the speed. So I have really bad move skill chance. Do I want that? No, I'm gonna go Dismas's head instead. Forget max health and all that. Add this stress. Okay, so those are the trinkets I'm gonna have. Now let's sort by activity. Make sure that there aren't things I can upgrade. Nope. I did a pretty good job of giving them the skills. What about equipment? No, it doesn't look like it. Alright. I guess they're ready. Taking a look at the blueprints here, is there anything I can cobble together? Yes, I could make a granary. That wouldn't actually be that terrible. I was gonna save up for the cartographer's camp. That sounds pretty good. Disease resist buff sounds nice. Gem stacking would be pretty nice, but that's way beyond my capacity to pay for. I could pay for the granary. How many blueprints do I have? I have two. I could pay for the granary and still have enough for the torchlight camp. Yeah, so let's go ahead and build our first granary. So we get extra healing for eating, and some food is granted each week. Okay, that's cool. Let's take a look. Crap there, and I really can't afford anything cool with my crystals. I just don't have very many. I'd have to do a farm run, but I'm not doing that right now. Before we head off, Loki Bay could use some stress relief. Okay, she could take stress... Oh, no, what am I doing? She could take stress relief. Let's see, tavern would be the cheapest. Everyone else is relatively good, so let's embark. Alright, so this is a Warren's medium. I have to provision for it. Just give me a sec. Let me bring up the provisioning guides. Warren's medium is food. Yes, I got some free food, as you saw. Some of that food that I just provisioned. Here, let me do that again. 10 food. Didn't have to buy it. Pretty nice, right? 3 shovels. Some... a bunch of medicine, because, you know. Some bandages, some keys. And some torches. Alright, that just about copies the guide. Yep. And embarking.
My zeal for blood rituals and summoning rites had begun to ebb, as each attempt invariably brought only failure and disappointment. Progress was halting, and the rapidly accumulating surplus of wasted flesh had become burdensome.
Okay.
The thing is more terrible than I can describe. An incoherent jumble of...
So the boss is going to be here. That's actually really easy to get to. I like dungeons that are laid out like this. And then I have this beautiful weekly extra damage in the Warrens. So this shouldn't be that tricky. I have my heavy hitter here going to hit hard. Real hard. His damage is ridiculously high. As you can see. 10% for Quirk, 25% for the Trinket, 15% for Town. And we're going straight to the boss. I can wander around after the boss a little bit. And what I might do is use up my firewood right before the boss fight, just for some extra bonuses to make the boss fight even more ridiculously easy. Oh, but that's a bad start. Let's see. Noxious. I probably could change the skills that Acid has. I'll take a look at that in a moment.
Back to the pit. Masterfully executed.
If you're wondering why I'm using the lower damaging stunning, it's because they skip a turn and my light level goes up. I've been asked about that before.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Yep, and they're all destroyed.
Success so clearly in view.
Okay, so given between those two, I'm going to go left for the double curio. Yeah. Fans are on fire. Oh, and a map, so I can look around even more. Moonshine Barrel gives me... Ooh. Now, here's the thing. If I use this on DeFay, he's going to get extra damage before next camp, so I'm probably not going to camp before the boss. I'll camp afterwards. That extra damage is going to be pretty nice. So, yeah, no surprise there. The boss is north... It's always the furthest from the entry. It's just the way it works. Bandages. And we just got a whole lot more food. And food is more beneficial now. So, as you just saw there, I healed extra eating it. That's pretty cool. Wow, this boss fight is gonna be so fast.
Eradicated.
I hope. Maybe it won't be. Maybe I've miscalculated and it's going to be way harder than I think it will be. But I doubt it.
Destroyed.
Hmm. I'm seeing if my heals could crit. Not that anyone needed heals, but let's see. 14 stress is the highest. Play a little tune for yourself. And fight's over. Not that bad, right? Horrors, brought low and driven into the mud. All right, so here's the boss fight. The flesh.
Squirming, contorting, and ever-expanding. This horror must be unmade.
All right, time for me to unmake a horror. I like that. I feel like The Witcher. Let's see. They have relatively decent stun resist. Blight resist is much lower. I could blight them. So I'm going to blight the first position. Let's see. I will try to stun one. Doubt it will work. Oh, it did work. Fancy that. Their protection is ridiculously high, so I'm going to mark for death the first one. And bring the protection down a little bit lower. And then I can start walloping next round. They're trying to stun me. They're still trying to stun me. I'm probably going to get stunned. Yes, I got stunned. No surprise there, because I have reduced stun. And then they just warped, or rather changed form? I don't know. They're sort of evolving. They're kind of like The Thing. What a good movie that was. Let's see. Harvest. Let's stack on the damages over time, because they have high protection. Oh, that's cute. They're healing themselves. So they all sort of share the same health pool, as you can see. Let's see. I need a big ol' heal on Tefei. Tefei's been the punching bag for whatever reason. Ooh, but you can't stun me now. And then they change positions. So high damage over time is definitely pretty nice in this fight, making them all bleed. And let's see, with that in mind, let's make them bleed. And they just keep healing. Heal all you want, I'm still coming for you. That looks pretty graphic. See if I get stunned. And I did. Alright. A new order. Alright, I guess I will just bash. Oh. Not bad. I should battle ballad. Keep those buffs up. See if I can't knock out a stun here. Yes. Stunning the stunner. That's how I like it. Require only the strength to follow it. Ooh, they're getting bitey. Oh, they're going after Acid pretty hard. That's okay. I'll get him healed. Let's go ahead and Noxious Blast one. They're putting their tanks in front. It's not going to protect you. I'm coming for you. Big old party comfort. And maybe some harvest. Give you the big old bleeds. Alright, so they have 4 hit points left. He's at death's door now.
And now the true test. Hold fast.
But it does not matter. Did I cut the light in time? Maybe, I'm not sure. Alright, I'm definitely going to continue adventuring. I'm going to bandage, and I'm going to campfire.
Circle in the dark. The battle may yet be won.
Let's eat a whole lot of food. And let's see, can anyone remove Death's Door? Usually you can. Nope. Nope. Okay, that can't be used on yourself. So never mind. Let's see. Encourage. Healing receive for battles. Let's give that to Tefei. And what else can we do? Accuracy and crit. Let's go with Sanctuary. Oh, we don't have Sanctuary. Alright, we'll just make Tefei a monster. Anyone have a 1 skill? No, we don't. Alright, so we're resting. We might get ambushed. We will see. Nope, we're good. Okay, so I'm going to continue with this dungeon just because there's more loot to be had. There's no reason to leave it. We do have Death's Door recovery, which is kind of annoying, but I'll make do. Unholy Hater. Cool. He does a little bit more to unholies. Alright, so this is a battle. Pretty standard battle. Look at those buffs.
Annihilated.
Alright. Unfortunately, I got Grey Rot. Which is... Huh, interesting. My health goes up, but my damage goes down. Nice, I dodged that. Alright, let's take their back line out.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
And try to stun ya. Make sure you don't get any turns. No turns for you. And the drummer's dead now. Gonna bleed out. Alright, Swine Wretch, you are my target. Ho ho ho! Sniped by our healer. Alright, what can I do here? I'll just... run the clock out. Oh, it didn't work. I was hoping to get a little bit more going on. Alright, so I ran out of room here. Let's go and see what we can toss out. I'm going to toss the citrine. So, what do we got here? We have the sacrificial stone, which usually adds stress, but sometimes can purge a negative quirk. So, anyone have a negative quirk we want to get rid of? Bunch of known cheats. They're all cheats. I have a team full of cheaters. Alright, we will... Nope, that did not work. That's okay. I was sort of expecting that. We have a lot of fights left, so I'm not worried about that at all. I can get that stress down. No problem. So... I'm not gonna bother going to the battles necessarily, because I think our inventory is going to fill up.
Staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Trapped him. So, stress is back up. If I have to de-stress it in the manual way, that's fine. Ooh, big guy. Good. I have extra damage versus size here, so I'm going to use it. hurts it, don't it? Harmless poke. That's putting their bloodletter in the back. Oh, don't punish me. I'm trying to get rid of my stress. Jerk. Unfortunately, my damage versus size isn't all that useful when he's all the way in the back there. That was a good hit. Let's see if I can't finish off that hit. And I can. Quit punishing him. And a crit? Are you kidding me? Poor acid. I'm like having a stress fight right now with this dude. Acid gets to get his stabs in at least. I didn't know come hither was gonna kill him. That's alright. Alright, Mr. Acid. I'm gonna give you some extra food. Alright, so we have enough for one meal left. In fact, Acid, you could wear the protection stone. You're getting beat up on a little bit. They know that you've been at death's door, and they just keep beating on you. It must be carried home. Trying to finish the task. We're gonna... Ooh, scouting, perfect. I get to know what everything is. Alright, so who... 70%, 100%. Let's go with the... I'm gonna go with the 70. Ah, man, he keeps getting stuck. Carelessness will find no clemency in this place. How have I failed 270% in a row? I don't know.
In radiance, may we find victory.
Can he fail for a third time? Succeed. I shouldn't gamble with that. I keep losing the gamble. Alright, now to... pile of bones. Alright, pile of bones gives us... we can cleanse it for loot. Cool. That's an extra torch. That we just used. That's our last hunger. We are out of food unless we find some food somewhere. I might be able to game this fight for extra stress relief. I'll try. We will see. Oh, that's going to be stress relief. That was a big heal, too. Let's see. Disorienting blast. The webs are annoying, so I'm going to hit a webber.
Executed with impunity.
I don't like getting stunned. I mean, I don't like getting blighted either. But stunned, I think, is a little bit more annoying. Down to 55.
Be gone, fiend. Another abomination.
Getting the killing blow helps with stress as well. And I'm gonna game it where I don't do anything for a little bit. Just to get his stress down even further. This fight is not very hard. I've been using the party comfort so that my crit rate is higher than just the individual heals, and it worked. My jester got the benefit. I like how I just keep pointing at the spitter. It's like, I see you, I see you, I see you. Alright, I'm at round 4, so I'm gonna finish this off. Confidence surges as the killing blow with my stressed dude. And there we go, we got a little bit more food, but that's not gonna be enough to feed anyone. Another pile of bones, let's go cleanse it. And I'm gonna backtrack a little bit. They don't like walking backwards, but it's easier than walking the whole length of that hallway that I know is basically empty. Alright, definitely want to get rid of that acolyte fast, because I didn't work all this time to reduce the stress only to have it kicked back up. So let's disorient you, put you forward, and have DeFace smack the hell out of you. Perfect. And your stumbling attack won't hurt me much. Or at all. Wunderbar. We're back down to 1 bar of stress. That's pretty good. Considering we were up at like 80-ish. Holy moly. That's a hit. Those little incisions actually do pretty good damage. Alright, now we're down to like 4 and 6. Not bad. And that 6 for the killing blow. Nope. I was hoping I'd get a little. Okay, so we just got 2 more food, which allows us to explore a little bit more, which is great. That extra food will give us another meal. I could fight through it. Let's just use that bandage outright. I don't see any shovels, so I'm going to ditch my shovels for the gold. And then journal pages is going to have to be there. I'm going to start gaming the light level because I'm just about at the end of everything that I can do here. There's only 2 fights left after this one. Put their stressors in the front. Ha! You missed. Bastard. And stun him for being a bastard. Don't stun me! No! Oh, I resisted. Tune? No, I don't really need to do a tune at the low levels of that I got. Alright, so their stress dudes are dead. I don't need to worry about them, just need to do the chopper and the slasher. I can't hit the chopper or slasher, so I'm gonna stun them forward. I like how no one has a turn, I'm just crowd control juggling these poor dudes. And the only turn they're gonna get, they're gonna bleed out immediately. Ah, oh, that was definitely gonna be a killing blow if I connected. Alright, chopper's dead, now it's just the slasher.
Slowly, gently, this is how a life is taken.
And now he's dead too. Oh, he resisted the bleed, never mind. Don't count him down and out until it's actually down and out. And of course I didn't game the light level system. Because I'm a doofus. I'm gonna bring the journal over that. It's already unlocked, so I don't use a key on that. And I'm going to ditch my antivenom. There's an opportunity for me to collect journals. I'm going to take it. They don't mean anything, but eventually, if you collect enough journals, you won't have any more journals to collect, and you'll stop getting them for loot. Alright, that's my last meal, but that did free up some space. I think it's time for me to use the remainder of my torches, gaming out the light level system for extra good loot. I was supposed to do that in that last fight, but I'm a moron and forgot. Alright, so what do we got here? We got some dudes that want to bleed. Ah, man, their dodges. I don't think it's actually all that good. I think I'm just inaccurate sometimes. They got a little stress off on me. And put tetanus on me. Very nice. Tetanus is just great. And let's see if our healer can't finish off this fight with some judgment. Nope, I cannot. And you get to vomit on another person. No, you don't. I got a turn. I'm gonna use that turn disorienting you. Nope, I'm not. Never mind. And I didn't do anything with the light level, but I still got pretty good loot anyway. Is a slow and insidious killer. Sapphire and crests. Okay, I think I will get that curio and then call it done. I need to, like, slap a post-it note on my monitor of snuff out your torch, you idiot. And just stare at that while I play. But it's fine, I don't really have the room for much else anyway. So, I risk it. And it didn't work in my favor.
That such missteps are the exception and not the rule.
Well, there's a dinner cart here. I'm not sure I'd want to eat from said dinner cart, but some of it looks edible.
Glittering gold, trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood.
Nah, I didn't pay for that in blood. All right, we're done here. Let's get them all home. One boss dead gives me the Demon's Cauldron, which is pretty cool. Allows me to debuff and stun. I have a whole lot of diseases to tend to. And she got the runs at the end of it. Now, I only have one character that can do apprentice level stuff.
They arrive with the East Wind, a torrent of whirling doom.
These dudes are like level dudettes, I should say, or level one, so I'm gonna pass on that. Alright, so diseases. Gray rot. Tetanus. And the runs. Boy, do I love... Oh, I actually have two people that can do apprentice level stuff, so let's take a look at the embarks. I don't know if I'm gonna have any apprentice level bosses left, so that's probably a good thing. Nope, known cheat just got locked in, but that's alright. Alright, unequip all trinkets and sort by rarity. Take a look at my stagecoach. Nothing super amazing in that. Nomad wagon. I don't really have a musketeer, do I? Yeah, that's about all else I could look at. So let's take a look at the embarkations. I do have the Fulminating Prophet. I've killed the lower level Prophet, but here's a Fulminating one. Gives... an interesting Plague Doc reward. What about Cove? That looks familiar. All right, so if I was to do a boss run, it would probably be against the Prophet. Alternatively, I could push the Warrens and Wield up, which I might end up doing because the Warrens and the Wield are lower level. If you look at the progress here, it's 5, 4, 3, 3. I'm just taking a look at what I could do. Fresh air in the tunnels. Let me take a look at the town events. Caregiver convention. That sounds good. I don't know what actually that does, but count me intrigued. All right, let's just take a look at the rewards for everything. Occultist damage. All Saints Day is pretty nice though. Martyr seal. That's probably a flagellant item to get. But I don't like flirting with death in that way. Okay, so let's go with... I don't know what Caregiver's Convention is off the top of my head. Let me look it up. Caregiver's Convention. Caregiver's Convention is the sanitarium is free. Ooh. Ooh la la. Okay, definitely doing that. Let's go sort by level. This is a veteran, but I'm going to take lower level veterans. The Wield, taking a look at the Wield, is... So the Wield is... They inflict bleeds and blights. Yeah, so it doesn't really... It's not all that important. Who I take. I don't have any high level, this is my only Hellion, so I'm going to take the Hellion. And likewise, I'm going to take Arcturus. Let's then... let's take a unusual off-healer. And maybe Tennille. That looks like a good lineup. Alright, so trinket them up. So you are going to get the Cleansing Crystal and the Healing Skills. Virtue, Stress... No, I probably just want damage on these guys. So Hellion. Straight damage. Actually, switch that up. And then... I don't need all these Protection Stones. I could really go ahead and sell like a lot of the stuff I got, as you can see. I have some duplicates, triplicates, etc., etc. So the Hellion will have more damage in position 1. Arcturus, you're going to have damage and speed and damage. We're just going to plow through this hard. And then Miss Digesta. Speed. Okay, that looks good. Provisioning. Let's go with... Oh, I love the free food. The free food is very cool. It's the Wield, so they're going to have a lot of barriers and boundaries. Like you do. Yeah, let's just do 2 of those. And torches... I'm not going to over-provision because I've been doing that a little bit too much lately. Let's get going. Not going to be able to finish this dungeon because of the lack of time, but at least I'll start it.
Our land is remote and unneighbored. Every lost resource must
be recovered. Okay, so I'm just checking that they have skills in the preferred slots that they're in. Yes, they're all in the right slot. Cool. We have to gather 3 medicines. Eerie Spiderweb, let's go cleanse with bandages. And already off to a good start. Troubling Effigy. I forget what this does. I know you cleanse it. Troubling Effigy gains a random positive quirk when cleansed. Alright, Hellion, I think that's you. Warren's Tactician. Alright, cool. I'm all about that. Some scouting will help find our way. Already having to use shovels. Wait, back. There's a quest location here. Yeah, I was staring at the medicine and didn't pick it up. I'm a big old idiot. Alright. Good. I'm glad I saw that before it was too late. Some left luggage. We'll unlock it. Damn! What? That is some valuables. Wow. Cool. I have never seen that before.
Nature herself, a victim to the spreading corruption.
Alright, so we know there's a battle in here. Get my light back up to radiant. And it's a bunch of stress idiots. Cool. Well, let's Abyssal Artillery them, and I have Inspiring Tune level 4, so that's going to be pretty powerful, bringing my stress level down. Missed. Don't pull me. Don't pull me. Resisted. Yes. Alright, let's Iron Swan this one. Boom. Damage. Damn. These guys are Eldritch, so I can't Zealous accuse them for the bonus damage. I'll do it anyway. That did pretty good damage, as long as they don't replicate. And, no, they're replicating. Boo, not cool. Well, at least that puts me Iron Swan for the last Enchantress.
Confidence surges as the enemy.
Good hit, Tynnel. Put her in the front slot. Make it easy to just whack. Oh, wow. She is a crit beast. Screaming that she'll feast on them. Alright, easy peasy. Fight, no problem.
Expedition at least promises success.
I'm gonna explore the southern path first. More eerie spiderwebs, more bandages for the spiderwebs. And more of these crazy tapestries. What's going on here? Is there something I don't know about this run? What to get rid of? Firewood. Sorry, firewood. Alright, so these are Eldritch.
Devastating blow.
Alright. I want to get rid of the ectoplasm quick so he doesn't just replicate himself.
Destroyed.
That was a nice hit.
Decimated.
I don't know if I did that in time.
Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Alright, so the Jute Tapestry in Darkest Dungeon. Let me look that up. What is going on there? I haven't really seen that before. It's just a rare piece of loot. That's what someone's online answer was. Alright. As long as it's not like a precursor to... And then you get jumped by some insane boss that was unexpected. I'd be happy. Alright, looking for the medicine. So I guess it makes sense that it, that the end of this is that I get some bonus stuff because, I'm getting all this medicine to make the sanitarium free. Alright, so 150 gold I'm gonna leave behind. Because I don't want to throw away any of my consumables at this moment. Because, yeah, I'm about to use my key. No idea how I made a ghost bleed. But I like it. Ooh, that's a good crit. No one has stress now. I should use the other ability, but oh well.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. Press this advantage. Give them no quarter. And now, the darkness holds dominion.
Black. And I get more keys, that's funny. Let's see. What am I doing here? 1, 2, 3, 4.
The match is struck.
Drink my holy water.
Star is born.
Take the gold. Open the chest. I should have, oh, Jesus. Okay. Throwing. 1, 2, 3 away. I'll keep a key. Man, that was a lot of heirlooms. I have to be careful about light level. It's going to get dark. But, you know what? That's probably a problem for future me, because I'm just about out of time. So I wanted to thank everyone that has been giving me all sorts of wonderful tips, like the one about using the plague doctor for diseases was from Jabuja. And if you have any other tips, tricks, feedback for me, drop me a line, and if I find it useful, I will announce it. And then your name will be immortalized in these videos. I also wanted to thank all of my patrons for allowing this channel to thrive and succeed. And I'll catch you all later. Thanks for watching. Adios.